The president will remain in Washington for Christmas. The first lady now returning to D.C. from Mar-a-Lago so they can spend the holiday together at the White House. This comes as the Senate has abandoned efforts to reopen the federal government until after Christmas. Senate leaders on both sides of the aisle, including Majority Leader Mitch McConnell and Minority Leader Chuck Schumer, arriving at the Capitol this morning amid a swirl of reporters trying to come together on a spending deal. But that did not happen. Senators, take a look at this, emptying the Capitol hallways, heading out for the holiday. In the meantime, hundreds of thousands of federal employees are facing furloughs in the nation's third partial government shutdown of the year. ABC's Tara Palmieri starts us off tonight from the Capitol.
Tonight, a deadlock on the shutdown. Both sides digging in. The impasse coming down to funding over the president's border wall.
Our great country must have border security. We need the Democrats to give us their votes.
Democrats not backing down.
President Trump, if you want to open the government, you must abandon the wall. Plain and simple.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell declaring the Senate out of session until after Christmas. Republican lawmakers showing little optimism.
Will it get done before Christmas?
Doesn't look like it.
I don't think so.
After a lunch with President Trump, Republican lawmakers indicated they would settle for less than the $5 billion the president wanted for the wall, but are balking at Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer's offer of $1.3 billion, which was lower than his offer before the midterms.
Does it have to be more than $2 billion?
Let me tell you what it's got to be. It's got to make some sense. I've never written a book, but if I wrote a book called The Art of the Deal, I don't think I would take an offer of $1.3 when you had previously offered me 1.6. You want to know how silly this is, America? Chuck Schumer offered today $1.3 billion for the wall after he had already agreed to 1.6.
As of midnight tonight, more than 400,000 federal employees temporarily working without pay, including some border security officials. Benita Brewer is a single mom working for Customs and Border Patrol and is being called into work, ruining her Christmas vacation.
I don't think that a lot of that is taken under consideration. When you hear of government shutdown, I don't think most people realize the number of employees that are truly impacted.
Offices that also remain open, Department of Defense, Veteran Affairs, and the Postal Service. Both sides arguing this is a political stunt.
The wall is President Trump's bone to the hard right people. It's no way to spend $5 billion for political bone.
They just have a hatred for Trump. They've won the House. They want the fight. They don't want to solve the problem. They're going backward, not forward.
All right, Tara joins us now from Capitol Hill. And Tara, Vice President Mike Pence late today made a visit to Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer's office to try and find a compromise to the wall funding.
Tom, my sources tell me that Pence came to the Hill with an offer of $2.1 billion for the border wall. That's much lower than the $5 billion that President Trump was originally asking for. He was also looking to loosen the restrictions on how the border security money could be spent. But Schumer's office tells us that, unfortunately, they're still very far apart. Tom?
Tara Palmieri with that new reporting tonight. Tara, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.